Hey everyone, glad to have you here. Today I want to show you something completely new, a fresh approach to creating speed ramps in DaVinci Resolve. Some of you might know my previous speed ramp tools on Envato, SpeedRamp Pro, SpeedRamp Seamless Transitions, and SpeedRamp Presets. They all work well and people still use them, but they're built on the classic anemone curve system with all of its natural limitations. So instead of trying to push that system further, I decided to create something entirely new from the ground up. That's how SpeedRamp Editor was born. Faster, more stable, and much more predictable because it doesn't rely on anemone curves at all. It runs entirely on smart scripting and automatically generates all the keyframes for you, which makes the workflow incredibly fast, accurate, and convenient. And now, the part I'm most excited about. Smart Mode is the feature that lets you build a complete clean speed ramp edit in just a couple of clicks without manually adjusting every keyframe, every curve, and every transition. It analyzes your timing, applies all the ramps automatically, and saves an enormous amount of editing time. The full version includes the code generator, which builds entire edits from your markers. But even in the free demo, you can already try Smart Mode using the ready-made montage codes from the library. Just load a preset and watch it assemble the whole sequence for you. Everything is optimized. Effects render only when visible, interpolation triggers only when the frame rate drops, and the whole engine avoids unnecessary calculations. The full version is nearly ready and will be released soon, but right now you can try the free demo version, which we'll explore together in this video. And one more thing, the full version won't be on Envato. It will be available in my new store, which means you get a lifetime license with free updates for one user. Buy once, keep forever. All right, let's get started. Let's take a look at the demo version. To install SpeedRamp Editor, just run the .drfx file and confirm the installation. Resolve will add the effect automatically. The performance still has room to grow, and I'll show you a couple of ways to keep things running smoothly. But this small compromise is nothing compared to how much time you save by skipping all the manual keyframing and curve tweaking. Before editing, set up your cache. Project settings, master settings. Choose a fast location and lightweight format, just like I show on screen. Then enable it via playback, render cache, user. This keeps playback smooth and saves disk space. And if your footage is heavy, you can always use Optimize Media. Just right-click the clip and choose Generate Optimized Media or create full proxies if you prefer. First, we add a footage clip to the timeline. The most important requirement is that the frame rate of the footage matches the frame rate of the timeline. If they don't match, use a compound clip. In this example, it isn't needed. You can find the effect in the Effects panel. Toolbox, Effects, PixFix, SpeedRamp Editor. We are working with the demo version. I double-click the effect to apply it to the clip, and the macros panel appears in the inspector. Let's go through it step by step. The timeline controller has two modes, hide and show. It enables a mini timeline in the preview window that helps you navigate when adding speed ramp jumps. There are also refresh and fit buttons. The fit button focuses the display on the active working area. For example, if the video is trimmed, fit zooms into the remaining segment. Below are manual zoom controls and the ability to pan the mini timeline. Main speed controls the base playback speed. Setting it to 0 stops the video. Setting it to 2 doubles the speed. In the preview timeline, you can see two playheads, red and blue. The blue playhead shows the remapped time of the footage. The red playhead shows the actual timeline time. At speed 2, the blue playhead moves twice as fast. At speed 1, they move equally. If you just need to add a few speed ramps to a regular video, set the base speed to 1 and place jumps wherever you need them. If you're creating an edit where speed ramps are the main stylistic element throughout the entire video, for example, a car edit, set the base speed to 0 and add jumps one after another to build the full motion rhythm. By the way, Smart Mode builds the entire montage using jumps, so it's also recommended to keep the base speed at 0 when working in Smart Mode. Below is the mode selector. Speed Ramp, Slow Motion, disabled in the demo, and Smart, the core feature of the project. Let's move to the Speed Ramp mode. Here we have two main controllers. Jump Duration, the length of the jump. Jump Strength, how many frames will be skipped or sped up. For example, with a small 27 jump duration and a high 82 jump strength, 27 frames can produce a jump of 82 frames. Pressing Speed Ramp adds a white segment in the preview. This is the jump zone. When playing the footage, you see the jump. The Move Playhead option enables automatic playhead movement after adding a jump. When enabled, you can add multiple jumps by simply pressing Speed Ramp. When disabled, the playhead stays in place and you manually evaluate the result. Below Jump Strength is the Max button, which sets the maximum possible jump, all the way to the end of the clip. The blue playhead also visually shows the acceleration zone. If the jump reaches the end of the video, a warning appears instructing you to trim the excess. Next is the shift parameter. It offsets the keyframes created by the speed ramp, allowing fine-tuning of the jump's exact position. For example, after adding a 50-frame jump, you can move the playhead and slightly adjust shift to refine the timing. If a new speed ramp overlaps an existing one, keyframes may stack and cause stuttering. To avoid this, follow the helper bar and stay within the allowed boundaries. Below is the frame interpolation controller. The SpeedRamp editor includes two interpolation modes, blend and flow. But here's the important part. Interpolation turns on only when it's truly needed. The macro constantly monitors the real playback frame rate. If the clip is running at normal speed or faster, the frame rate is full, so interpolation is pointless. It stays disabled and doesn't waste any GPU power. If the clip slows down and the frame rate drops, interpolation activates automatically, generating missing frames only in the affected areas. This means no wasted processing, no unnecessary optical flow. Smooth, slow motion exactly where you need it. Massively faster render times. Efficient, smart, optimized, exactly how interpolation should work. Now let's move to effects. The demo version includes two effects. The full version has many more. Effects support auto and manual modes. Auto applies the effect during high-speed movement. Manual allows you to apply the effect wherever you choose. Each effect has its own settings and manual animation controls. At the top are a mount master and a mount limit. Point of interest is unavailable in the demo and used only in the full version. A mount master controls the overall strength of all effects. A mount limit restricts the maximum intensity. A high master with a low limit gives a longer, softer effect. A high limit produces a sharper effect. Now let's move to the smart mode, the most advanced feature of SpeedRamp Editor. Smart mode requires two timelines, the main one and a placeholder. Their frame rates must match. For example, if the main timeline is 30 frames per second, the placeholder must also be 30 frames per second. I create a new timeline. This will be the placeholder. I add all footage clips I plan to use. Here you simply organize your clips, trim them if needed, follow camera motion, and build a rough assembly. Once the placeholder is ready, I place it onto the main timeline. Then I apply SpeedRamp Editor Demo to the placeholder and switch to Smart Mode. In Smart Mode, you see two areas. On the left, your footage time codes. On the right, the montage code area. To get the time codes, open the placeholder timeline, pick the first clip, and apply SpeedRamp Editor Timecode Extractor. It works in cut points mode and extracts the timestamps of each edit point. You can also gather time codes manually using markers, but cut points is more convenient. If Copy to Clipboard is active, the result is copied automatically. Pressing Get Time Codes generates the list. Each line represents a cut point in seconds. Paste this into the left Smart Mode panel. The SpeedRamp Editor also includes its own Get Time Codes button. It allows you to extract time codes directly from timeline markers without using the separate Time Code Extractor macro. This is useful when you place markers manually on the timeline at cut points, and then combine your footage into a compound clip. Once the markers are set, just press Get Time Codes, and the macro will read all timeline markers and generate the time code list automatically. So you can extract time codes in two ways: using the standalone extractor inside the placeholder timeline, or using the built-in button right inside SpeedRamp Editor. Next, we need a montage code. You can find them under Info, SpeedRamp Editor Stuff, and Tuts. There is a small library of music tracks and ready-made montage codes. In the full version of SpeedRamp Editor, you can create your own montage codes from scratch. You simply place markers on the timeline following the music, beats, accents, or any moments you want, and the macro generates a complete montage code based on your timing. You can also use colored markers, each with a specific function. Green markers add extra jump cuts inside a segment. Red markers create reverse segments by flipping playback direction. Purple markers placed in pairs to create bypass sections without speed changes. You can additionally enable random boomerangs and jumps, letting the system automatically add dynamic motion where it fits. And here's the smart part. The script automatically adapts the montage code to the exact number of clips you have. Whether you use more clips or fewer, the macro intelligently redistributes all segments so the final edit always stays balanced and synchronized. Together, these tools let you build fully custom, rhythm-based SpeedRamp edits with complete control, while the system handles all the heavy lifting. You can also save your montage codes, reuse them in future projects, and even share them with other editors. This makes your SpeedRamp style fully portable. Once you craft a rhythm you like, you can apply it to any footage, anytime. And for the demo version, I've prepared several ready-made montage codes for you. Simply open the Info tab, click the button, download the music, copy the code, and you're good to go. It's an easy way to try the workflow and see how Smart Mode builds edits automatically. Choose a track, preview it, download the audio, and copy its montage code. For example, if the code contains 36 groups, you need 36 clips in the placeholder. My example uses exactly that. Paste the code into the right panel and add the music to the timeline. Now press Apply. The montage distributes automatically across your clips. After applying, you can trim excess parts if necessary. If you see sharp transitions or overshoot, simply reduce the speed and press Apply again. The script recalculates all curves and smooths the timing. All effects in SpeedRamp Editor work the same way in Smart Mode. You can use auto or adjust everything manually. Before we wrap up, here's a quick look at what the full version offers beyond the demo. In SpeedRamp mode, you can fully customize the animation curve of every ramp. Make it sharper, smoother, or perfectly linear. You can switch curve types with a single click, creating any motion pattern without touching keyframes manually. Reverse ramps are also included, letting you create boomerang-style shots or clean rewind effects. The full version unlocks slow motion mode, where you control both the duration and the intensity of the slowdown. And just like in the demo, frame interpolation, flow, or blend activates only where the frame rate actually drops, never wasting performance. You also get 6 additional effects, with more coming in future updates to expand your creative toolkit even further. And of course, smart mode. In the full version, you're not limited to presets. You can generate your own montage codes for any music, viral audio, or even a single clip by using markers to shape the rhythm exactly the way you want. All updates after purchase are completely free, and I already have plenty of ideas on how to push this system even further. Plus, the full version comes with a lifetime license for one user, including commercial use. Pay once and it's yours forever. That's it for this walkthrough. If you want to try SpeedRamp Editor yourself, the free demo is available right now. The link is in the description. If this video helped you, feel free to like, subscribe, or drop a comment. It really supports the channel and helps me create more tools like this. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.